Grace, mercy, and peace be unto you from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Our text for this morning is taken from the Epistle of St. Paul to the Romans, the 5th chapter, verse 10, in which we read, "If while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of His Son, much more now that we are reconciled, shall we be saved by His life." This is the text. Dear brothers and sisters in the Lord Christ Jesus, when we go through these high points of the church year, I can't help but feel nostalgic. And I'll tell you, nostalgia isn't necessarily a good feeling. Nostalgia means a painful homecoming. It means actual pain of heart when you think about the past, things as they used to be. I'm sure you can look back on past Easter Sundays. You can probably think of past Easter Sundays right here in this building and how things used to be. I think of growing up in southern Indiana, having two Easters. One Easter with my Lutheran side of the family and one Easter with my Greek Orthodox side of the family, getting twice the chances at candy, twice the chances at long church services. But it really is painful to me to remember those things because they're in the past. They're memories. Some years ago, back when we were watching Food Network before Paula Deen fell from grace, I watched one of her episodes where she was making some kind of elaborate dessert, and as she would always do, it had lots and lots of butter and sugar and lots of heavy, sweet and creamy ingredients. And she said, "We're making memories." That was kind of a refrain throughout this episode. If you make this with your kids, you'll be making memories. And for some reason, that really depressed me. Why would it depress me to think of baking something in the kitchen so as to make memories? It's always perplexed me. Why did that get me down so much to hear her talking about making those memories? Last week, I think I finally put my finger on it. Here's the thing about making memories. When you make a memory, you're freezing a moment in time. It's something that stays there in the past. It's like a souvenir. It's like a picture of a good time that you have kept in a glass cabinet. And it's nice to remember that. It's nice to look back at it. But the thing is, it stays in the cabinet. It stays in the past. It remains but a memory. When I look at a lot of sympathy cards that are produced today, since we don't have much of a bold proclamation of the resurrection of Christ anymore, what we have instead are things like, "Your loved one lives on in your memory." But that's precisely what I don't want to hear. If my loved one lives on just in my memory, that means my loved one remains only a memory. You can't hug a memory. You can't hold the hand of a memory. A memory remains in the past. So if we're going about making memories, there's nothing wrong with that. We just have to be aware that we're setting ourselves up for heartbreak in the future. We can't live on memories that will destroy us. It will fail us in the end. And what about when our own memory goes? What about when we can no longer look back on those things that bring us such joy? No, if we're looking for memories, we're bound for disappointment and heartbreak. But that's just what Easter is about. It's about getting beyond memory. Easter, of course, involves memory. It involves looking back on something that happened in the past. It involves reflecting on the absolute reality of the bodily resurrection of Jesus Christ, a historical man who walked with a historical body on a historical earth. It involves looking back on that and knowing for certain, knowing for sure, that this real man rose in his body from the grave and appeared in history to his disciples who remembered that. They made memories with their risen Lord, and they wrote down those memories so that we could share in those memories and look back on them. But those memories aren't a purpose unto themselves. Those memories serve another purpose. Those memories serve to give us hope. You see, the Christian faith isn't ultimately about memories. The Christian faith is about hope. It's not about looking back on things that we can never relive. It's about looking forward at joys indescribable that Jesus Christ has prepared for those who love Him and are called according to His purpose. And as St. Paul says, our hope does not disappoint. This hope is summed up for us in this text from Romans. If while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of His Son, much more, now that we are reconciled, shall we be saved by His life. Just a couple of days ago, we were all gathered here for Good Friday to commemorate the death of our Savior. And we somberly reflected upon all that God accomplished for us by the death of His Son on the cross. What Jesus did on the cross was He reconciled us to God the Father. He removed the hostility that had existed. Because God, in His righteousness, had to punish our sin. He could not receive us into His presence. He was at enmity with us. His righteousness required that He destroy us in His wrath. But the death of Jesus, you might say, deflected the wrath of God from us. Jesus suffered the full weight of God's wrath against the sin of the world on the cross so that we could be reconciled to God and be at peace with God. But that's only half the story. Because as St. Paul says here, if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of His Son, and we certainly were, we were brought into a relationship of peace with God through the death of Jesus. Well, much more, now that we are reconciled, shall we be saved by His life. Jesus didn't just die for us. He also lives for us. He rose again triumphant from the grave as the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep to give to us the sureness, the certainty that we too will rise from the grave as He did. And on the last day, with a trumpet call, He will call out to all the dead, and they will come out of their tombs to live before Him. And what that means for us is that we don't just look back at the memory of Jesus' resurrection, but we look forward with hope to the promise of the resurrection of all the dead on the last day. So take some of those memories that you especially cherish, things you remember from your childhood, from your own children's childhood, things you remember about loved ones who have since departed this life and gone on to glory. Think about the pictures that you have in your home that have crystallized for you in the past, times that made you especially happy, but that are now, in a way, inaccessible. Think about all of those memories that are in the past, and think about how God has so much more prepared for you in the future. Those loved ones whom you remember, whom you cherish, they're not just there for you to remember, they're there for you to look forward to. Because Jesus will raise them triumphant from the grave as He was raised triumphant from the grave, so that together we can stand side by side before God in His kingdom and live before Him in righteousness and innocence and blessedness forever. It's good to have memories. It's good to have memories of Easter's past. Good to have memories of loved ones. We cherish those things. It's good to make memories. But let us never put our hope in our memories. Let us rather look forward in hope to what has been promised us in Christ, the hope that is ours through His glorious resurrection from the dead, a resurrection that He has promised to all of those who believe in Him and who trust in Him and will come finally to inherit the kingdom of His Father, prepared for us from the foundation of the world. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Hallelujah. And now may the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.